Alright, welcome back to Let's Play Black Closet, and this time I'm going to try not to go more than double the time like I did last time. I apologize for that. So, let's return to the game, and we have no active tests. So, what that means is we're going to go ahead and... on some days, nothing wants to take a 5 penalty to all skills in one activity. So we're going to give this to Mallory and have her go to the supply closet. Oh. That sucks. Okay. And then we'll... I don't want to send anyone to the training room yet. So we're going to wait. Excellent. Okay. So... Teresa's the only one that's had a failure. Vaughn has had several unclear. Althea actually seems to be doing pretty good, so I'm not, like, a huge fan of her, but I think that we can not count her. Rowan has had 5 unclear, too. So I think we can not count her, but then these 4, I'm just not sure. Teresa tends to be my biggest... suspect because of how she acted about her sister not getting the vice presidency. So let's go ahead and visit. Knock on the door. Oh, okay. Let's go to open night at the coffee house. Open night, you mean we get to perform? That sounds like fun, actually. Wait, are you going to perform? Do you want me to? No. It would distract from my spotlight, you see. One beautiful young schoolgirl, all in white, that's a novelty. 2 is a field trip, 2 means comparisons. I'd win, of course, but it wouldn't be the same. She tosses her hair back. Anyway, shoo, I have to get ready. I'll meet you later. The coffee house is a warm, intimate space filled primarily with students and young professionals. The 2 of you in your white uniform stand out from the crowd, but not enough for anyone to stare. Teresa arranges her performance slot while you carry the drinks back to the table. When her turn comes, Teresa walks onto the stage with her head down, her long hair hanging over her face. All of a sudden, her head snaps up, her eyes blazing. I am the orange with the razor inside. I am the poisoned kiss. She goes on like this, piling up colorful and violent imagery with manic fervor. Several short-haired college women in the audience look practically entranced. At last, she cuts off her poem in what sounded like the middle of a phrase and freezes in place, her hand upraised, then slowly lets it fall. As the audience applauds, Teresa walks back to your table. I think that went well, don't you? Let's act like we know what we're talking about. Is that cryptoglyphism? That's just not intended to be overanalyzed. It simply is. Teresa sits back with her drink to watch the rest of the lineup perform. Thanks for coming here with me tonight, Elsa. I really appreciate it. And you should appreciate it as well. You have witnessed a limited edition performance. No autographs. Speak to my manager. Do I go, I am your manager, or I already have your signature? Explaining the student council privileges, it's good to be the queen. I believe we should be heading back now, Mustn't overexpose. Let's go. Okay. So then, another person, like Vaughn is the only one that has more unclear than successes, so we're gonna go ahead and visit her. You go to Vaughn's room and knock on the door. Would you like to go planetarium or, let's say planetarium. I'd love to, thanks. You head to the science museum where you bypass the super high definition movie displays to walk into the largely empty planetarium. The seats are large and comfortable, and it's not at all difficult to find 2 of them together. You lean back and wait. Eventually, a program unfolds a fly-through projection of first the solar system and then the entire galaxy. While listening to the narrator's soothing tones, you hear a strange little sound coming from nearby. Vaughn? Was she about to say something? You're sure you heard her breath catch. You wait, but her attention seems totally focused on the stars overhead. Outside, after the show, Vaughn seems subdued. She walks beside you, offering no words. Did you enjoy it? Oh yes, it was lovely. It's just... I suppose the stars make me a bit melancholy. They're beautiful, but they're so far away. Even when they're projected on the wall, they're so close at hand, they'll never be in reach. Well, maybe never is too strong a word. Strike boldly into the future to explore new worlds and new horizons. Or am I only dreaming? Someday people will travel to the stars. Someday. I suppose we ought to get back. Thank you for coming here with us today. Here with me today. I... She pauses, blinking, takes a breath but says nothing, and then lets it out again. Elsa? You think everything happens for a reason? Why do you ask? Things happen we create. This one's a hard one. I'm gonna say, why do you ask? I wonder sometimes whether I'll ever know if I'm here because I'm meant to be here or if it's all just chance. And when to take a chance and when to trust that everything will work out as it's meant to. Sounds pretty deep. You'd be surprised how shallow my thoughts can be. Don't mind me, please. Too much time in the dark with my mind wandering. We'd better get going before I start telling you how we're all made of star stuff. Okay, when you have items and supply... Okay. Begin week. Urgent. Ashley reports that her roommate Mandy never returned to their room last night. Her whereabouts are currently unknown. She may be lost or injured or even kidnapped. Does her best friend Tamara have any information? Susanna has been heard saying that her friends Sanja and Tammy are planning a surprise that will shock the entire school. Investigate urgently. So both of these are urgent cases. Alright. So in that case, we're going to... Let's actually... This is... less urgent. So let's go Mallory and question. Her social should be plenty. But we'll go ahead and add the crystal ball as well, just for a good measure. And then we'll harass these two. Then have her inspect, and then we'll question Susanna. Okay. Question. Okay. And then we'll question Tammy as well. All right, let's go. Damn. I know she wasn't happy at school, but I never thought she'd really do it. Shit. Leave me alone. We're not doing anything wrong. Success. Find Mandy's diary, which talks about her favorite places to go in the city, especially the cathedral. This is a clue. You may now explore the city. Too close to call. As I promised Sanja and Tammy, I wouldn't tell anyone about their plans. But I'm worried what they'll do. And excellent. I know what you're talking about. Okay, so she's going to require Mallory's absence due to stress. That's fine. Okay. So, let's send Rowan. I just send her to explore the city and hope that it all works out okay. Okay, and then these two harass 79%, and then that makes it 100%. And then we'll calmly and patiently question Tamara. Go to the cathedral. Success. There she is. You catch up to her before she sees you. Success. You sneak up on Mandy and drag her back to school. Yas! Success. Oh, god damn it! Okay, so Sanja's not helpful. Tammy might be able to harass. Or do we want to stalk? Let's... Well, for Sanja, let's go ahead and stalk. And then for Tammy, we'll try harassing her. And then we'll question her. Doesn't seem to notice you following her, but you don't learn anything new. Damn it! I promise that. Okay, that's the same thing. Oh gosh. Okay. So we're gonna have Rowan stalk her. I think we, and then we'll also stalk Sanja, and then we'll also stalk Susanna, and then she's not gonna be happy about it, but I need stuff from the supply closet. See if we can't learn anything new. Don't learn anything new. Seems to notice you following her. Probably because while you're stalking her, she is stalking Tammy. This is suspicious. Now you can search Susanna's room. Yes! Animal decoy. That's nice. An envelope was sitting at the school council in tray address to Elsa Jack. Shit. Not an assignment from Mrs. Talmadge. This came through the regular mail and stamp postmark, but no return address. Inside the envelope, you find a 3-kiosk printed photographs, a picture of you walking across campus, taken from some distance, a picture of a window set in a stone wall, like the walls of the school building, and a zoom in on the window at night, just enough to make out the familiar confines of your own bedroom. The last item of the envelope is a matte black rectangle of heavy cardstock, the size and shape of a business card, but entirely without text. The only mark printed on the card is a teardrop of red in one corner, small enough to cover with your thumb. It's the only way they know where you sleep. With no other clues to go on, the only thing to do is set aside for a moment and go on with your work. Oh, he's absent due to stress. Okay. So. Decoy. And. So we'll keep the animal decoy, I guess. Throw them in there. Have fun, go and get some stuff from the supply closet. And then those two get a break. Success. Success. Find Santa's area where she talks about how much she dislikes Sandra and Tammy and hopes they'll get expelled. The suspicious now. Yas! And then I have a sedative. Okay. So, Rowan has had a lot of successes. I think we can take her out of the equation. Fawn is doing... So Althea is doing good. Mallory is doing pretty good. So I still think that... I think we're right to focus on Vaughn and Teresa. And I tend to think it's more Teresa. Would you like to go to a movie? A movie? I guess we could. I'll get my purse and then we can go. Cinema front is decorated with posters of various films and marquee of showtimes. You pick the film, I'll get the snacks. No popcorn, it gets grease all over your fingers. Maybe candy if there's something nice. She waves you on as she looks at the list of films. After you return with your snack, she hands you a ticket and you proceed into the cinema together. You settle in to watch a movie about a young woman attempting to win the interest of a rich businessman's son through her talents in ballroom dance. Of course, there's a big misunderstanding and they part with tears and anger, requiring an even larger scheme to get them back together. The happy ending comes with a dance number that seems to incorporate the entire city. Teresa rolls her head around on her shoulders, stretching her neck. That was fun. I mean, it was predictable, almost cliche in elements, but those elements were put together well. Too bad it wasn't a musical. It's even more of a show if everyone's singing, too. Can you dance? What sort of question is that? We go to the same school. Did you sleep through your lessons? If you mean, can I dance like they did, then no. I haven't practiced in years. So anyway, thanks for the trip. Ta! Okay, now let's visit Vaughn. Would you like to go to a coffee house? What? Well, I suppose as long as you don't expect me to perform. You know, we'll perform and then see how she responds to that and see if it works against us later. Really? All right, Captain, I'll be there. Shall we? Yes, one, two of you in white. Okay. You delegate one to fetch drinks and choose seats while you sign up for the performance slot. Your name is called, you head to the stage. Take place in microphone. Let's wax philosophical. We have some points of discussion from a class lecture on philosophy and expand upon them, avoiding the temptation of false profundity in favor of reasoned analysis. Talking like this doesn't get cheered, but at least a few of the audience members seem interested in the subject. The next performer marches onto stage and you return to your seat. Vaughn is quietly amused. Was it that bad? Of course not, it was enlightening. After that, the rest of the show is unremarkable. Thank you for a lovely evening, Captain. I'll escort you home. Okay, suspending a student is a strong punishment. Most guilty parties will break down and apologize after being suspended. If suspension isn't enough to stop bad behavior, only expulsion remains. Okay. Looks like a false alarm. Damn. And Beverly have been circulating dark rumors about Nanette. She's secretly a witch plotting a curse. Okay. Oh, and the school property has been defaced in the lower dorm. Various surfaces have been blackened and scarred. What's happened here? Investigate. And then Rowan's gone. Okay. So, for this one, we need to inspect. I'm thinking of giving that to Bob. And then, she's a goth, so then we'll give Teresa to harass, and then can question her, and then question her. And we'll hope for the best. Okay, success. You find a few drops of candle wax. Someone is trying to set a fire. There's... Damn it. Success. I heard she keeps a cat's skull in her room. Everyone knows Nanette is weird. Okay, so looks like we're focusing on Nanette. And it looks like, god damn, look at my karma. This sucks. So we inspected, and then we can do a stakeout. And then here. Okay, wait. Let's take this back. And what if those two did it together? Okay, I can't take any more, any more drop to my karma. So, let's talk with Nanette politely. So I can either add that, well, let's just add that. And then we go to the supply closet and get supplies. And then I can add and then let's say just a freebie to get rid of that stupid oh damn it, I keep doing the wrong thing. Shit. You hide and wait while Mikaela sneaks and looks around for it. This is suspicious. You may now question, harass, or stalk Mikaela. You may now search Mikaela's room. Okay, success. I'm different from other girls, but feel free what they can't understand. Sunglasses. Okay. And then we want to increase her social. So we want to search, then we add sunglasses to the mix. Oh, how long do I have? I wish this gave me like an end date of when I had to have this done by. So let's see, it's only Wednesday. So, what we're going to do is take this off, and then we're going to send Rowan to the training room. Then, yeah, no, this isn't going to work. Oh, okay, but we can't question her. She is still my best option there. And then say I want to search. Okay, neither of those will work. Let's guard. That should be okay. And then supply closet. So I'd like her to have more stealth, just to make things easier. I don't know what you're talking about. Success. You stand around, but nothing happens. Hall pass. Excellent. Okay, so now we can do this. Go in here. And search, and sunglasses, and hall pass. And can we take off? Okay, yeah, we can take off the sunglasses and just use the hall pass, and we have 100%. And then then we go to Michaela's room, and then we go search, and then we go sunglasses, and that's a pretty good ratio. And then what if we want to harass her? That's 100%. And what if we equip this? Doesn't matter. We still get... Okay. And then send Althea to the spy closet, even though she hates me. That's okay. And then, so... Okay, you quietly search. And then what happens? Okay, you find a cat skull in some place like this is suspicious. And now we can detain Nanette. Yas. Okay. And now we're searching Michaela's room. And please, for the love of God. Okay, excellent. Okay, so we can search Michaela's room. And now... God. Ah. Mother. Fuck. Okay. So now we can intimidate her. Success. Leave me alone. Okay, you may now question, harass, or stalk her. Stalk Florence. I don't know. Okay. Leave me alone. Florence said she'd break my fingers if I tattled on her. Okay. So now we can move on to Florence. Okay. Shit. And then if I were to put these on. What if I put everyone's on? Nope. Oh, okay. This hurts. Okay. Well, then we'll just move on to Nanette, and then we will detain her. And then not her, but these two. Okay, no, that works. Okay, so we are going to assign. And then for Florence, we're going to question with Mallory. And then we're just going to add the candy for good measure. Then we're sending her to the supply closet. And I'm sorry if she's unhappy with that. Not really. But, yeah. Success, and it sulks all through attention. Seems like you're not getting... Oh, damn. Okay. It says, I don't know what you're talking about. High heels. Okay. Look at 12 success, only one failure. So, like, it seems like they were supposed to intentionally fail. And actually, Teresa looks like she's doing better. So, the one that still is, like, not doing as well is Vaughn. So, is Vaughn our sneak? Would you like to go to a picnic? Sounds like fun. I can... Okay, follow Zia to school grounds while you look for her. While you look for a place to spread your blanket. Secluded location. You find somewhere out of the way where you're less likely to be interrupted and set the basket in the shade of the tree. You spread the blanket and Vaughn kneels upon it, her legs folded beneath her, her hands resting on her thighs. May I look in the basket? What have you brought? So what's something she would like? So, sandwich makings and salads from a grocery store, hamburgers and fries. So I don't think those... It's between fajitas and rice and sandwich makings and salad. I'm gonna say fajitas. That sounds nice. Not too much for me, though, please. Bonnie slowly looks elegant and relaxed in a natural setting. I'm sorry, I don't have anything to offer you. If we'd planned this earlier, I would have brought dessert. It's nice to be able to sit with you out here in peace and quiet, not like when we were young. No matter how much the teachers told them to behave like ladies, girls will be girls, even the bells of St. Claudine's. Running, screaming, chasing people around, kicking up clouds of dust, do you remember? I can't picture you roughhousing. I was never one for fighting, that's true. I was always far too small. Not like Althea, who towered over the rest of the playground. I did my share of running around, though. Tammany and Rana and I... You wouldn't remember them, but we did climb the swing and all of that. I even sprained my ankle chasing Rana down a hill when she was in a wagon, and I... Never mind, it was silly. Relaxed kneeling positions, letting... Her legs open to one side. People have strange expectations of little girls sometimes. thinking that we're all little lacy powder puffs, adorable and innocent, and just waiting to blossom into beautiful women. Thank heaven for little girls, a ridiculous song probably written by someone who has never known a little girl. We can be vicious and brave and disappointing. Huh, Vaughn. Vaughn, what's this? Her eyes meet yours for a moment, and then her gaze falls away. I suppose I should go. Thank you for your time and the picnic. Goodbye. Vaughn. Vaughn. You owe me some answers, Vaughn. Alright, let's... Would you like to go on a picnic? Let's go to a movie. I suppose. I don't have anything particular planned for today, shall we? Various films... I'll pick the film, you get the snack, you want to eat here? I admire their business sense in ruthlessly exploiting a captive audience, but it's all grease and garbage. She shrugs. I'll get you popcorn if you want. Box off, leaving you to peruse the items. Currently on offer are animated children's films, something about gangsters, something with guns and opera singers, a historical romance, and some sort of dance film. So, let's see. Do we want... What do we want? Let's go Noir Northwest. After she returns to with the popcorn, you hand over the ticket and proceed to enter the cinema together. You settle in to watch the movie about old-time Seattle where well-dressed gangsters squabble over territory and murder each other in dark alleyways. Unfortunately for them, bodies dropped into the Puget Sound have a tendency to resurface. The whole affair ends with the chief villain slowly choking to death inside his exclusive bar, surrounded by cronies who refuse to assist him. Althea yawns and stretches. Good movie, huh? It was exciting. I don't suppose you could get the teachers to add a snazzy fedora to the school uniform. Do you? Your sister would object. If it's not required, Teresa wouldn't even notice. If it's required, she'd have fun finding a way around it. Besides, I was only joking. Anyway, I guess we'd better be heading back. Okay. So, I have to do it by the Harvest Festival. Honestly, it looks like Vaughn is our culprit. And I am past time again. This game is just so interesting to me. So, I guess I'll have to end it here. We'll go ahead and save, and I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.